patient is in cardiac arrest.
Do you want to connect that? I'll do the chest. Yep.
I might have to bring him out from that wall a little bit.
Yep. Yeah, his heart stopped beating at the moment, sweetheart. What's his name?
Paul.
Paul, okay. Okay, Paul.
In Australia, around 20,000 people have a cardiac arrest out of hospital each year. It takes only 3 minutes for brain damage to set in.
Fives are on 238.
Every minute that goes by...
could have another Bravo crew code one, thanks.
Paul's chance of survival drops by 6%.
Hey, we're not happy side. He's very sick.
Yeah, very unwell, darling.
Injecting adrenaline can improve the chances of the heart restarting.
28, 29, 30.
How about access here?
Okay. But with no blood pressure, Andrew is struggling to access a vein.
5, 6 years ago, I diagnosed with a heart condition. And while I'd been to people before of a similar sort of age that were having heart attacks or who had actually were in cardiac arrest, until I actually got diagnosed with this, it actually made me really realise that maybe get that little bit more empathy for what these people are going through.
Not at the moment.
Your compressions?
Yep.
No joy there. But if you get caught up with something too much, you can't really help people. So the more you can keep a lid on your emotion and what's going on, the more effective you can be.
Just stop for a sec. Just want to see if you've got a pulse. Nice, got a pulse rate of 36. Yeah, got a heart rate of 67 now. OK, you've got a heart rate of 100. That's good. All right, we've got a pulse back.
Sorry. Your husband's heartbeat at the moment, which is good.
He's still not looking very good at the moment, but at least his heart's beating. He's got a pulse. We've got another crew coming. As soon as we get him stabilised, we'll be taking him to Prince Charles. He's just taking a breath, which is a good indicator. I can't promise you anything. He's just taking another breath now. So he's breathing.